constant struggle with great pleasures, great fears, despair, loneliness, the utter lack of love, the loneliness, the boredom, the repetition, the routine. That's our life. Spending 40 years in an office or in a factory, being a housewife, the drudgery, the dullness, the boredom of all that. The sexual pleasure, the jealousy, the envy, the failure of success and the worship of success. That's our daily tortured life. That is, if you are at all serious and observe what it actually is. But if you are merely, if you seek entertainment in different forms, whether it is in a church or in the football field, then such entertainment has its own pains, has its own problems, and a superficial mind does escape through the church and through the football field. And we are not dealing with such superficial minds. That's because they're really not interested. Life is serious. And in that seriousness there is great laughter. And it's only the serious mind that is living that can solve the immense problem of existence. So, our life as it is, lived daily, is a travail. And no one can deny it. And we don't know what to do about it. We want to find a way of living differently. At least we say so, at least some of us say we must and make an attempt. Before making an attempt, before trying to change, we must understand actually what is. Not what should be, but actually take what is in our hands and look at it. And you cannot look at it. Come close to it. Intimately contact with it. If you have an ideal, or if you say this must be changed to that, or if you are concerned in changing it, but if you are capable of looking at it as it is, then you will find there comes a quite a different quality of change. And that's what we're going to now. First, to see actually, not shyly, or with reluctance, or with pain, or with resistance, what life is actually at this moment, at this And every day, it is that extra vein. And can we look at it? Can we live with it? Be in intimate contact with it? And to be in direct relationship with it? Here comes the problem. To be directly in relation to something, there must be no image between you and the thing you observe. Right? Are we following this? The image being the word, the symbol, the memory of what it was yesterday or a thousand yesterdays. That he serves, to put it very simply, the relationship that one has with one's wife or husband is the relationship based on an image. The image being accumulated through many years of pleasure, sex, nagging, dullness, repetition, domination, and so on, so on, so on. You have the image about her, and she has the image about you. And these two images, the relationship, the contact between these two images is called relationship. And obviously, that's not relationship. But we have accepted it as relationship. So there is no direct contact with another human being. In the same way, there is no direct contact with the actual, with what is. There is always the observer. Please do follow this little bit, maybe a little complex, but it's not, if you listen quietly. There is the observer and the thing observed. And there is a division between this. And this division, or the screen in between, is the word, is the memory, is the space in which all conflict takes place. That space is the ego, is the me. The me is the accumulated image, memory, thought of thousand yesterdays. So there is no direct contact with what is. You either condemn what is, or rationalize what is, or accept it, or justify. All verbalizations. Therefore, there is no direct contact.